Massachusetts Governor Charlie Baker, as we mentioned, has extended the stay-at-home advisory to May 18th, which means another tough couple of weeks for non-essential businesses that remain closed. I spoke with John Hurst, the president of the Retailers Association of Massachusetts, to hear more about the situation and what he's hearing from his members.
You know, when you think about where the retail sector and restaurants and small businesses and really our entire economy was, you know, until about the end of the first week of March, we were in unprecedented positive territory. All-time high, record high sales, record high employment. Our economy was just really going gangbusters, you know, well under 3% unemployment. Our members were seeing, frankly, very strong monthly increases, around 8% or so, from really last fall, October, right through the Christmas, the holiday shopping season, and January and February. And then all of a sudden, we hit a cliff. We fell off.
And when you think about it, when that first announcement came out, when there was the emergency order declared by Governor Baker, you thought, okay, maybe a few weeks of this, and then it just kept getting extended as we saw what was unfolding across the country. That has to be devastating for businesses.
Well, no question about that. When the emergency order was done, that, you know, that was even before it was the stay at home and closed essential, non-essential businesses and so forth. There was about a little over a week, that period there. At that point, people stopped spending before they even were told to. And then came the second order with the stay at home, shutting up non-essential businesses, and that was going to be for 3 weeks. So really, we were talking about 4 weeks there, taking us well into about mid-April. And I, you know, at that point, our members were thinking, well, you know what, we're in this together, we can get through this with our customers. And then lo and behold, the second order came, and it was going to be adding on to the initial 3 or 4 weeks, another 4 weeks. At that point, we were starting to get very worried. And we started to ask the administration about a little more flexibility in the order to allow, say, a mom and pop florist or jeweler or apparel shop, bookstore to do online commerce, to take phone orders, to do deliveries, curbside and so forth. And really that flexibility never came. And then we came around to this week, and it was somewhat anticipated, another 2 weeks added on to take us to May 15th. There is still some things that we must do to try to give these small businesses a shot at a future, including allowing, you know, clearly allowing an employee or two to be in a closed block store, to take phone orders, to take internet orders, to do deliveries, curbside. The reality is that is occurring and is currently legal in 49 states. Massachusetts is actually an outlier when it comes to allowing in-store fulfillment to try to stay alive and try to continue to connect with your customers.
Do you think that's even a reality, though, with just 2 weeks left to go?
Well, we're pushing it. I mean, look, we've gotten to the point that a lot of businesses have actually started ignoring the order. You think about florists. Technically, you look at the FAQs, florists are supposed to be shut. They are not supposed to be open. And you think that we went through Easter, with all these funerals that we've gone through, and technically, they were not supposed to be servicing us. Yet you could still go on 1-800-Flowers, right? And they were kind of ignoring it. You know, the internet large sellers were ignoring it. You could also go into your local grocery store and pick up flowers as well. And, you know, that really didn't make sense either from a competitive standpoint for a local florist to not be able to operate and serve their customers, yet a grocery store could, nor it didn't even make sense really from a health standpoint. Right now we have a situation where we have a lot of small businesses, a lot of florists that frankly are ignoring the order, and they have to start servicing their customers and taking phone orders and deliver for Mother's Day. And same thing for whether you're a jeweler or apparel store, they're starting to try to have a future and sell their inventory.
And what do you think as far as some businesses not even being able to open back up? I know there's been an infusion with the stimulus packages, but problems there as well with programs running out, and now there's more money coming for the payroll protection plan. But how do you, what are you hearing from your members as far as people thinking, I'm just never going to open again?
Well, look, our members have seen a 75% reduction in sales. And remember, that includes our numbers from our grocers, our convenience stores, hardware sellers, appliance sellers, and some of those that are, quote, essential alcohol sellers that are still opening. We're allowed to open. And it includes the majority of our members that are, quote, non-essential and haven't been selling anything. 70% reductions in retail sales over this period of time. 80% have laid off or furloughed, 80%. The retail sector is one of the largest layoff levels in the entire state. You combine us with hospitality and food, it's about 30% of the layoffs. Look, what we're really concerned about, and when you start looking at the PPP, the Payroll Protection Program, 92% of our members have applied for that. There is growing frustration there that even if they get in and they get the money, that money becomes, under federal rules, a loan, not a grant. Because under state rules are saying that you cannot hire people back and have them work behind a locked, closed door. You see the disconnect between federal rules that you have to have payroll, you need to have people working for you, and the state rules is that you cannot have people working for you in a locked store. So Massachusetts, probably more than any other state, is heading their small businesses towards a reality that the PPP becomes a loan, not a grant. And the last thing any small business wants are more loans. Now, I can work from home and do Skypes and Zooms and so forth. So can a law firm, an insurance agent, and so forth. But there are certain businesses that deal directly with the customer that they need to be in an establishment, even if it's not face-to-face. You know, they need to be there to do internet and fulfilling inventory. And so you need to have that payroll. You need to have some safe operations to give them hope that they don't have to pay that money back. That's the frustration with the PPP here in Massachusetts.
How are you advising them then? If that's the option, what's the next option?
Well, you know, they're taking it day by day, week by week. All we can do is hope that there'll be some loosening up, you know, under the current state order, allow some flexibility, allow you to bring it back maybe one person per store, just like New York has, you know, for a locked store, have someone, you know, servicing your customers. If you're a florist, have somebody that's doing the phone call orders, someone else doing the arrangements, someone else that's doing the deliveries. Same thing if you're a jeweler, you know, some level of minimal employee activity to serve your customers so you can have that payroll so you don't have to pay that money back. You know, a lot of these small businesses, their credit tends to be not from banks, not from the SBA. It's from their suppliers, their inventory suppliers. That's where their loans really come from. I'm buying clothing for the spring selling season, and you pay me back, you know, as you're selling it. You know, that's the credit terms that they live under. And right now, unfortunately, they cannot sell that clothing, so they cannot pay back their suppliers. And the reality that they haven't been able to, that they're not open and they have to pay their landlords, rent and suppliers are the two critical problems that a lot of small businesses are running into right now.
And tell me a little bit about what you think it's gonna look like. Let's say we do open May 18th, and I think a lot of people, you know, have reservations because there's been, you know, deadline after deadline that keeps getting pushed off. If we open May 18th, what will business be like for the florist, for the gym, for the hairdresser, even if they all come online at the same time or spaced out?
Well, I think we've learned a lot from the, quote, essential businesses, whether you're a grocery store, or a hardware store, appliance store, and the like. You know, there are a lot of things that we can do that tell the customer that Yes, you need to be cautious. You, the employee, need to be cautious as well, but you don't need to be fearful. You know, there's a big difference between fear and caution. And we need to instill that in our consumers that they are very, very important to our economy. They're 70% of the economy. And if they are cautious with face coverings, and if the employees are cautious with face coverings, and they have the CC sanitation efforts and hand washing and sanitizer available both for the employees and for the customers, and keep the proper 6 feet social distancing, and our grocery stores, you know, are limited to 40% occupancy. These type of standards that we've already lived with and are frankly working very well in the essential establishments can easily be transferred into another type of retailer, into a restaurant, into an office building, a warehouse, to all types of establishments. We need to, you know, still be careful, still be cautious, but not be fearful.
What do you think about the pent-up demand? I know that's something that economists have talked about. And obviously, there's great hope that once everything is open, that we, you know, snap back. What do you think that would look like in Massachusetts? I mean, there's a lot of people that need haircuts. There's a lot of people that can't wait to go back to the gym, that need to go to the mall to buy clothes. Do you think there's going to be that kind of demand and rebound that's going to help these businesses get moving again?
That's a great question, and there's a lot of hope in that question as well. Pent-up demand, you know, the consumer can turn on and turn off like a light switch. I think in this reality, it's going to be more like a dimmer switch, right? I don't think they're going to come back, you know, day one of May 18th and splurge, whether it's going out and shopping or going out to dinner or whatever. It's going to be step by step. I think the reality is it's going to be not just weeks, it's going to be months. I think before they feel comfortable and they're spending at the level that we saw back in February. You know, it's going to be interesting. Something like Memorial Day weekend will be very interesting to see a test on what consumers do as far as getting out of their homes and doing a few things. That normally is one of the biggest weekends of the entire summer. You know, it's the kind of the traditional kickoff for summer, right? Whether you're going shopping or you're going you're barbecuing, you're picnicking, you're going to the beach, whatever you may do, going out to dinner. It'll be interesting to see, number one, if we're allowed to do that, you know, if it doesn't get extended again, and to what extent. And number two, what will be the consumer reaction? Will they cautiously go out step by step and invest not only in themselves, but invest back into their main streets? Because, you know, we need the consumers to both feel comfortable health-wise that they can do this and do this safely. But we also need them to understand that it's important economically that they do this. They, more than anyone, the consumer is 70% of the economy. If they're not comfortable and if they're not spending back on our main streets and back into our economy, it's going to be a long, long struggle. No matter if you're a retailer or a manufacturer or whatever line of business you're in, it's going to be a long struggle to get this economy running again.